Hello students, welcome to Analog and Digital Communication Laboratory. Myself, V. Naresh, Lab Assistant, Department of ECE. Following are the list of experiments. Fifth experiment is design and verification of PAM, PWM and PPM. Here PAM means pulse amplitude modulation, PWM means pulse width modulation, PPM means pulse position modulation. Hi students, today we are performing the pulse amplitude modulation and demodulation. And this is the circuit diagram of the pulse amplitude modulation. Here, the modulating signal is given to the collector terminal and the carrier signal is given to the base terminal. Okay, now this is the PAM output. The output is taken across the emitter terminal. And this is the pulse amplitude demodulation circuit diagram. Here, free cut-in frequency is fc equal to 1 kHz. Here means condition is f equal to 1 by 2 πRC and resistor is 150 ohm, c is 1 microfarad. And this is the demodulated signal. Okay, now next observe, this is the carrier signal and this is the modulating signal. Here the pulse amplitude of the pulse is proportional to the amplitude of the modulating signal, is called as a pulse amplitude modulation. Here, okay, now this is the pulse signal and this is the carrier signal, this is the modulating signal and this is the PAM output. Okay, now the modulation circuit and demodulation circuit connected above on the breadboard. Okay, now next to switch on the power supply, and here channel 1, my modulating signal frequency is 1 kHz, amplitude is 4 volts, and carrier signal is 10k, amplitude is 5 volts. The two signals are given to this circuit, and output is taken across the emitter terminal. Okay, now this is the pulse amplitude modulation. Here, amplitude of the pulse is proportional to the amplitude of the modulating signal. Next, observe the modulating signal output is given to the input of the demodulation circuit. Output is taken across the capacitor. This is the demodulation circuit. And this is the demodulated signal. And observe the frequency. And go to cursor 1 and go to cursor 2. Okay, now and this is 1 millisecond, nothing but frequency is 1 kHz. This is the demodulated signal. Okay, now this is the pulse width modulation circuit diagram. Here, modulated signal is given to the 5th pin, and carrier R pulse signal is given to the 2nd pin. Okay, now here tau equal to 1.1 RC, and tau means pulse signal frequency is 22.7 kHz. Okay, now next this is the demodulation circuit diagram. Here demodulation circuit diagram is connected, cut-in frequency is fc equal to 1 by 2 πRC. Here r equal to 150 ohms and c equal to 1 microfarad. Cut-in frequency is 1 kHz. Okay, now and this is the diagram. And this is the pulse signal and this is the modulated signal. Here the width of the pulse is proportional to the amplitude of the modulating signal. Okay, now this is the pulse, this is the modulating signal, this is the pulse width modulation circuit, pulse width modulation output. Okay, now here width of the pulse is proportional to the amplitude of the modulating signal. Okay, now the same circuit is connected above the breadboard. Okay, now here modulating signal and carrier pulse signal is given to this circuit, and observe the output across this. And this is the, here this is the pulse width modulation output and this is the modulating signal. Okay, now next observe the demodulation circuit. Thank you. है ना, दिस इज द डिमोलिशन सर्किट एंड फाइंड आउट द कटिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी. ओके ना, अप्रॉक्सिमेट 1 मिलीसेकंड नथिंग बट फ्रीक्वेंसीज, मॉड्यूलेटिंग फ्रीक्वेंसीज 1 kHz. दिस इज द मॉड्यूलेटिंग सिग्नल एंड हियर आर द डिमोडेट सिग्नल. दिस इज द पल्स विड्थ डिमोडेटेड आउटपुट एंड दिस इज द पल्स विड्थ मॉड्यूलेटेड आउटपुट. ओके, दिस इज द सर्किट डायग्राम ऑफ द पल्स पोजिशन मॉड्यूलेशन. हियर दिस इज द अस्टेबल मल्टी वाइब्रेटर. हियर मॉड्यूलेटिंग सिग्नल इज गिवेन टू द 5th पिन, दैट इज फ्रीक्वेंसीज FM 1 kHz एंड प्रोड्यूस 5 volts. And the pulse signal is internally generated. That frequency is f equal to 14.5 kHz. The condition is t equal to 0.69 into Ra plus 2Rb into C. Okay, na? And this is the demodulation circuit diagram. This is the cutting frequency fc equal to 1/25 Rc. Here f equal to 1 kHz. The resistor is 150 ohm. C 1 microfarad. And this is the demodulated signal. And next. Here, this is the pulse position modulation, means the relative position of the pulse is proportional to the amplitude of the modulating signal, and this is the pulse position modulating signal. Okay, this is the pulse signal and this is a modulating signal. Here the position of the pulse is proportional to the amplitude of the modulating signal. Okay, na? The same circuit is connected upon the breadboard. Okay, na? Then next, here modulating signal is given to this circuit and observe the output across the 3rd pin, and this is the pulse position modulation. Okay, na? Next, the modulating signal is given to the input of the demodulated circuit and output is observed across the capacitor. Okay, now observe and find out the frequency. Okay, now this is 1.05 milliseconds. Nothing but frequency is 1 kHz. This is the modulating signal frequency, and this is the demodulating signal. Okay, now this is pulse position modulation.